To Horry. Horry for three, lets it fly. Yes!
Bryant, it's it off. Horry for three. Good!
Ball tipped out to Horry, a straight on three. Good! The Lakers have won!
Oh, they to Horry for three. Oh, unbelievable!
This guy is off the charts.
It's a make or miss league. And in my case, it's a make or switch league.
Still my favorite. Still so good. All right, make degree of difficulty, and the man is not lying. Just saying. All right, Luka hit not one, but two ridiculous shots in the closing minutes of the
make
third.
It rain.
All right, so Rob, if you were in the league today, how would you defend Luka?
You know, I'm asking for a double team. You have to double team, get the ball out of his hands because he's too crafty, and he can make so many things happen. And you watch this guy, like, he's not fast. He's not quick. How is he getting his shot? No, but he's just Luka.
Yeah, Luka plays at his own pace. And
yes.
I played in the playoffs against Jeff Van Gundy's Knicks.
Okay.
And he double teamed me at half court coming up, and he made me get rid of the ball at half court and make somebody else make plays. So I'd try it, you know, and see what happens.
I mean, I will say that there were several times I saw Luka just weave right around a double team last night.
This
just
is
sort
true.
Of like, nah. Nah. Miss footing. PG getting KP on the switch, drops to the hardwood. We showed you this one earlier, too.
It's a roll on.
Well, R-rated from PG-13. He started the game good. I mean, this is what's just crazy, is that he and Kawhi both had fantastic first halves, and then you got to play the second half.
Look at that. I mean, it's just...
Yeah. But these, okay, in all seriousness, though, you talk about defending Luka, you've got Paul George and Kawhi Leonard, who are supposed to be two of the best defenders in the game.
Especially with Kawhi Leonard, I thought he'd be one of those guys that's strong enough, tall enough, and quick enough to guard him.
Yep.
But Luka's finding a way to get that rainbow shot off on him and doing certain things.
He's a gifted offensive player that knows how to get his shot and plays at his own speed, like you said.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, make elevation. Let's get over to the Lakers-Suns game. LA out and running. LeBron climbing the ladder.
Go get it.
Packs it with one hand. So, Vince, you have some experience with doing stuff like this in year 18. How does it change as you age as a dunker?
How does it change?
It's
mentality. It's just mentality. Like, for him, you know, you can't tell him that he's not able to do that at 38. I mean, it's just in him until you believe that you can't do it. That's all I got.
You got certain guys that are just incredible athletes. Vince, you were one, and LeBron's another. He could probably be at 50 dunking, like Spud Webb was. You know, he was dunking at 50, so LeBron going to be dunking it a long time.
Robert, Vince Carter dunked on that hoop the other day at age 44.
I saw that.
I don't know about 50.
In a suit.
But he's getting there. I don't want to prematurely age you, but, you know. Miss posterity, Anthony Davis taking the flat-footed jumper, then catches Jay Crowder in a sensitive area. It was ruled a flagrant. AD said he apologized. He said that Jay knew it was not on purpose. Good call, though, for the flagrant, Rob?
You know, it set a precedent when Draymond Green did it, and so it's kind of like, oh, we got to do the AD thing. But I think when guys are shooting out, every guy kicks out now because that's just what they do. And he just happened to be in the wrong spot at the wrong time, so I hope there's no punishment for
that. You know, with the fadeaway shot sometimes in that position, the kick is what gets you there sometimes.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate, but they have to call it.
Well, you're trying to draw that call, too, now that they're calling not being in the landing space, right? So they're trying to get that.
Right.
We thought it might be fine, though, to run it back to the jump's most memorable below-the-belt hit, 2016. You mentioned it, Robert. LeBron firing that pass right to the groin of D'Angelo Russell. So I guess this was not the Draymond one, but yes, same year.
Man, this is weird, though. It's like LeBron, his passes come quick, fast, and with some heat. And that hits you right in the bread basket. That one's going to sting for a long time.
2013, Boogie sets a screen. Dennis Schroeder takes some exception. Here we go.
Oh, no, that's a flagrant.
Yeah.
That's a flagrant.
That's a flagrant.
2015, Rodney Hood with the and one. Steven Adams just in the wrong place at the wrong time on that one. That's just.
So you look out below in two different ways.
Yep. No, you don't. Yeah. But he was very funny about it afterward. 2013, Carlos Boozer to the ref.
Oh, man, I remember this.
Right? No, he's like, wait, I did not mean to do that.
And one more.
I'm shocked that this doesn't happen a lot. So guys are so animated now, they can get hit in the face.
Paul Pierce almost knocked a ref out. Number 2016, we all knew this was on there, right? Oh, we're getting here back to this one. This is the below the belt on Steven Adams. Ooh. Right?
Are we picking on Steven Adams today?
Man.
Again, you know what it shows? It shows that, right, that he's willing to stand in there and take
one for the team.
Tough. Yeah. No? Okay. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.